How long have you been in this business, Joy?
12 years.
12 years. What if the first year, as you were, go back to your first year, you made a decision that you wanted to, as you were becoming a broadcaster, those first couple years are rocky, they were for me, you decided, while I'm doing this, I want to build my brand, I'm going to do a lot of social media, I'm going to be very active. Do you think that would have helped your broadcasting part?
No.
Exactly. Exactly. That's why Tom Brady didn't have a brand for 10 years. He was just winning Super Bowls. And Kobe Bryant didn't have a brand for 7 to 8 years. He was just Kobe Bryant. Baker Mayfield decided simultaneously as he's learning the game at the pro level, I'm going to be in 48 commercials. Look at his Twitter the last month. They're all commercials, all shot in the offseason. Joe Thomas is the best Cleveland football player in 20 years. When LeBron James left Cleveland, you can't criticize Baker. You can't question Baker. The Steinbrenners left. The Rockefellers left. You know, LeBron left. People leave Cleveland. They don't come from all over the world with that being the destination, like LA or New York or Paris or London. They leave Cleveland. And LeBron left, and Baker's the guy. So criticism will not be taken well. But Joe Thomas acknowledges the Baker he has seen early this year is concerning. Yeah, maybe it was the marriage this year, which is awesome, but there were 350 people. I've been married. That takes up a lot of time. Or the 13 commercials, or the 3 or 4 massive magazine portfolio interviews, which took multiple days. You know what Lamar Jackson did this offseason? Because I just looked at Lamar Jackson's neck and arms and body. Joy and I in the pre-show meeting, Lamar Jackson got 10 pounds bigger. There's a reason Lamar went from I'm not sure to holy hell, what's that? Because he didn't get distracted this offseason. We never saw Lamar Jackson this offseason. I watch these NFL games. I see Baker Mayfield on commercials. He's not even in the game. He has 13 of them. He chose the route, which I don't believe is the route Joy and I should take. Be great, then worry about your brand. He's not great yet. He's not, frankly, through two games, even good yet. Right now, Lamar Jackson's the better NFL quarterback. Winning, passer rating, touchdown quarterback, interception ratio. Lamar Jackson's significantly better. And Lamar Jackson didn't spend the offseason shooting 19 modeling things and having 14 articles and 19 commercials. This is why I said with Baker Mayfield, what did he? I mean, I'm not saying he didn't practice, but then you throw in the fact that OBJ missed some camp and he missed some practices. That's not ideal. And then Freddie Kitchens was right in your hip. He was your guy. And then now Freddie becomes the head coach. So Freddie's got to coach the team and he's not your valet anymore. And the fact that last year you played 7 of the worst defenses in the NFL. And this year you're playing 6 of the best pass defenses in the NFL, so the schedule is harder, and the expectations are huge, and Baker's want, oh, I'm going to build my brand while I get good, and I don't believe in this. And I said it going out. I never liked Mark Sanchez doing all the modeling stuff. Get good at football. Get good at broadcasting. Worry about your brand after you got a few, you know, pelts. Tom Brady's first 7 years, I think he had one big commercial. It was a Visa commercial. He sat at a table with a bunch of offensive linemen. He did an Uggs commercial. But Tom Brady didn't really have a brand until about 4 or 5 years ago. After Tom won the Atlanta Super Bowl, Tom said, okay, now I'm going brand heavy. And he does. He did the documentary. But you can do that after like 5, 6 Super Bowls. Kobe Bryant's first 7, 8 years, even as a Laker, Kobe Bryant, he was a basketball guy. And then Kobe started doing a lot of international stuff, the China trip, selling shoes. That's good. You got rings. Baker's not even a good NFL quarterback yet. So Joe Thomas is like, yeah, it's kind of disturbing. It's not unpredictable. Rookie head coach, tougher defenses, 13 commercials, 9 magazine articles, getting into fights with talk show hosts that America loves me. That's outrageous. And he did get married, and I think marriage is cool. But I would have said if I was him to all these commercials, because I'm already making a fortune. I was like, you know, a top pick. I've already got millions. I would have said, I got to be honest with you. I'm getting married, and it's a really important thing for my life. And my wife's amazing, and I have to invite 350 people. And the only routes I'm going to be running this year are going to be between the florist and the caterer. this offseason, and maybe the wedding photographer, because weddings are awesome, and I love this moment for Baker Mayfield. But a wedding is time-consuming and hard. Add 13 commercials, bunch of big articles. Freddie Kitchens now the head coach, not your valet. OBJ's kind of there. This is not unpredictable. This is why I don't believe in – I occasionally – I'm going to go speak – at the Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State here in the next few months. I do a couple of these a year. And when I go and speak to all these young people, I'm like, before you're cocky on the internet, get good. Before you're snarky and cool on the internet and eliminate jobs, because I've literally got to the internet and said, okay, I'll never hire that guy, never hire that guy, never hire that woman. Why don't you get good before you get cocky? Why don't you get good before you have a brand? Why don't you worry about being a pro? A committed teammate like Lamar Jackson, who has made a unbelievable leap. I mean, like jaw-dropping. Like, what? I went this morning, joy is my witness, you were in the room, right, when I said, Lamar Jackson doesn't even physically look the same this year. There was a shot in our monitor as I'm doing prep this morning, and I said, how much weight, his traps, his arms, his shoulder. Look at Lamar Jackson.
Yeah, he's a grown man now.
He's like a man. That's what he did to this offseason.
Right.
He spent it in the weight room 4 hours, you know. Look at him. He don't even look the same. That's what you should do. I don't even know. Does Lamar have commercials? I've never seen one. He wins a lot more than Baker. Lamar's like the talk of the league this morning. Patrick Mahomes and Lamar are the talk of the league.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay? This is what I've said about Cam for years. Cam's sometimes distracted by being Cam. If you don't think brands are hard to build, you know how many people I have in my life working on my brand? I've got an agent, a business manager, a social media person. It's time consuming. And I'm off at noon. What if I was a quarterback and I was in the office for 16 hours? So this is, listen, for Joe Thomas, if Joe Thomas talks in Cleveland, listen. Joe Thomas is smart. He's the best football player in the state of Ohio for the last two decades. He's one of the top five tackles in the history, maybe, of the league. Remember when Baker, never forget this, remember when Baker took a shot at Duke Johnson, the running back? Remember the running back came out? All Duke Johnson says was, we got like three great running backs. I just want to get some touches. There was nothing wrong saying that. By the way, Jared Goff in L.A. wins 80% of his starts. I've never seen him in a commercial.
Period.
I've never seen Jared Goff. He's in Los Angeles. We got 19 movie studios. I could throw a frisbee and hit eight of them from where I'm standing. Never seen Jared Goff. He wants to win before he's a brand. All right. Hi, everybody. Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show. Also, be sure to check out more of the best clips from The Herd or go watch a few segments from other shows on FS1.